Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In this video, we are going to discuss section 7.12, locative, temporal, eventive subject. As we have stated before in section 7.11 and 10, that subjects can be assigned to other roles or functions. Here today, we are going to discuss the roles of locative, temporal, and eventives to subjects. Number one, the subject may have the function of designating a place or time. So it may refer to place or time. This path is swarming with ants, which means ants are swarming all over this path. So this path here is not an agentive. It refers to place. The bus holds 40 people, which means 40 people can sit in this bus. So the pass here is a place rather than an agentive. So unlike swarm, the verbs in such sentences do not normally admit the progressive. We can't say the pass is halting. It is any grammatical or the passive, which means or such as 40 people are held. So in this sentences, the subject has the locative or refers to place. Functions or assigning the locative function to subjects. Intemporal subjects can usually be replaced by the empty it, the temporal expression becoming adjunct. So here subjects indicates to time. Tomorrow is my birthday. Tomorrow here as a subject, it refers to time. It can be this sentence can be paraphrased into "It is my birthday tomorrow." The winter of 1970 was exceptionally mild. It was exceptionally mild in the winter of 1970. So the subject here doesn't refer to an agentive doesn't have the agentive function. It refers to temporal or time. The third kind is eventive subject. Eventive subject, which designating the arrangements or activities, differs from others in permitting intensive complementation with a time adverbial, such as the concert is on Thursday, but we cannot say the concert hall is on Thursday. إذن أعزاء الطلبة ممكن انه يكون للسبجكت كما ناقشنا في السكشنات السابقة انه قد يكون يشير الى اللوكاتيف اللي هو البلايس تمبرال اللي هو التايم اور ايفنتيف اللي هي الاحداث اذا يشير لنا الى البلايس مثل this path is swarming with ants اذا this path هنا معناها شنو معناها مكان the bus ايضا مكان وممكن انه تعيد صياغة الجملة لكي تتأكد من هذا بعض الجمل رغم انه هذا الفاعل ما نقدر نخليها بالبروغرسيف ولا ممكن نخليها بالباسيف لذلك يجب الانتباه إليه مما يدل على أنه الفاعل ليس agentive وإنما هو هنا يشير لنا إلى اللوكاتيف النوع الثاني هو temporal subject اللي يدل على الأزمنة ممكن أنه في هذه الحالة temporal subject can be replaced by empty it يعني هذا it هي empty يعني مدل لنا على أنه الفاعل هنا يكون شنو يكون agentive لكن هنا يكون the temporal expression يصير adjunct مثل tomorrow is my birthday فtomorrow هنا هي الفاعل ممكن انه تعيد صياغة الجملة وتكون it is my birthday tomorrow eventive subjects تدل على الأحداث arrangements or activities وهنا ممكن differs from others ممكن انه تسمح للintensive complementation with a time adverbial مثلا the concert is on Thursday ما ممكن تكون the concert hall is on Thursday